मेरे को तो अनेकों ऐसे लोग दिखाई देते हैं
that unlimited we see many people we think that is we think it's our own
pehle jis kisi prakar se vaishnavo ki kripa se
somehow by the mercy of vaishnavas because of the greatness of this vaishnavas
sila gopal krishna maharaj
whether it's Srila Gopal to his Maharaj Prabhuji speaking with our experience coming through Gopal Krishna Maharaj Mahanidhi Maharaj after coming in the and through that we heard the Vani of Srila Bhaktivinoda Swami Maharaj at that time very young like a small child and we even though a lot of time has passed having darshan of Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj by his mercy and by his mercy that's somehow we can accept something understood what is Gaudiya Math somehow with association came to Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj and through him we got association of Srila Bhakti Vikan Bharati Goswami Maharaj
bahari roop mein to hota ja raha hai kintu hriday mein koi parivartan nahi hai
externally we are meeting but we don't feel anything happening you know changes in our heart whatever they are saying
usme se kuch bhi palan karne ja kar ke
whatever they are saying
thoda sa bhi yadi chesta karne ka prayas hota hai
whenever we try to follow
except asafalta milti
hai we just find we are not successful just going again and again we try to follow the instruction but we are not able to
isliye hota hai dur nagari bari dur nagari
so therefore we feeling bari dur nagari that is very far very far the Narottam Das Thakur is thinking se teen samsar aur na ke ho nahi that there is no one besides you in these three worlds
bhari roop mein to ye bhi dikhai de raha hai
externally we can see
kisi ek vaishnav ne
that some
taraf se bahut prayas kiya
that vaishnav was endeavored but he left this world
fir koi aur vaishnav
then some other vaishnav
fir koi aur vaishnav and then some other
in that way
hota ja raha hai
vaishnav is coming
samay bhi jata ja raha hai
time is also going and vaishnav is coming and going
aur kisi ka bhi abhav anubhav nahi hota
and unfortunately we are not feeling any lacking in we are not feeling separation from them that Narottam Das Thakur se pasani koti bal anale pashibo
gauranga guner niti kota gele pabo
singing that how
when even
those vaishnavas we have come in the association of
swayam
they themselves gave mercy gave make the relation with us some they've come and
unki taraf se hua sab some
they've tried everything from their side still in our heart no mood is coming in our heart that really something has changed in our heart
वैष्णव
हैं
उनका संग करने के लिए
जाऊं देयर आई शुड गो टू वैष्णव एंड आई शुड लिसन कथा एंड सर्व देम एंड गेट देयर कृपा इज नॉट हैपनिंग इन आवर आई कैन नॉट डजंट कम इन माय हार्ट इवन दो हियर
हृदय में कभी कभी
sometime you know
that
somehow desire come in the heart okay I should go and visit some Vaishnava but still then nothing comes actually. Then I remember Srila Maharaj's words. Sunni granthi achani badhi.
जैसे कुछ किसी के पास में उत्रिया है, किसी के पास में दुपट्टा होता है.
जैसे व्हाट इज उत्रिया, दैट मीन आउट अ पकलत.
छोटे थे बहुत,
व्हेन वी वर वेरी यंग,
माता जी के दुपट्टे में
दैट
गांठ लगा करके उन्होंने 2 रुपए रखने, 5 रुपए रखने.
They used to, in the olden days, the ladies, they used to put a knot and put some money, some rupees, 5 rupees, 10 rupees. But in the Kirtan, what is
it?
Sunya Granthi, now Acharyas have sung one Kirtan, Sunya Granthi Achale Pandiya. Even though we put not, we didn't put anything valuable in that knot. That even though we can see the note in,
but we have not
put anything valuable in that. Ways in the olden days, people used to put a note and I put some wealth, some notes, some rupees in it. So Maharaj is saying, who is that? One who is well, who is intelligent, who is mentally well, he doesn't put a knot with nothing in it. He doesn't put a knot with nothing in it.
अर्थात धन नहीं है जिसके पास, कोई सिक्का रखने के लिए या नोट रखने के लिए नहीं है जिसके पास.
He one doesn't have any wealth. He doesn't put any note because he is mentally, he is intelligent. But who is mentally sick? What does he do? He makes note. He makes knots, even he makes knots in his cloth, but there is no rupees or no wealth. Why does he tie this knot? Because it depends what kind of person it is. Because he doesn't understand what is going on, he sees others have got no knots in their cloth. He doesn't understand why, he doesn't know why people have got knots. So himself, he put knots on his cloth. He doesn't know what to do.
Or
he puts knots just to fool others, or to cheat others, to just say, I've got something, I've got some wealth, so I'm putting this knot. Do you think I've got nothing? So there are people like that also. Some do it, to cheat others, some do it for and some do it in when they are not well, but they are not able to accept the essence. So now I am seeing that is that it is coming to, I mean, the same situation. Many things I think I am seeing. That I am in the association of Vaishnavas, so many have become a sadhu. I am staying in the ashram. I have given up my family. And many I have served many Vaishnavas. I am trying as much as possible. This is, I'm just mentally, I'm eating laddu and I'm cheating others. Reality, without duplicity, if I consider my situation, then I realize that actually I've just tied knots, that I've not got anything in my knot, in my cloth. Few days ago, I spoke with Bhakti Kinkar Damodar. He was saying, Prabhuji, what does Mahaprabhu say?
Kahare kahibo keba jane mor dukh.
Tar kahibo keba jane mor dukh.
Mahaprabhu
is saying,
apne man ki baat bataun.
Who will I tell the mind, my dukh of mine?
केवा जाने मोर दुख क्यों आपके साथ अनेकों लोग रहते हैं
who can understand with, even though I stay with devotees, who will understand, who can understand my dukkha, who can my distress?
अगर अभी किसी को सचमुच में भी अपने हृदय की बात पहली बात तो बोलने की इच्छा नहीं करती
बस नो डिजायर टू टेल
अपनी स्थिति के ऊपर
टू टेल अदर्स अबाउट माय सिचुएशन सम टाइम आई लाफ एट माय सेल्फ एंड सम टाइम एंगर एट माय सेल्फ
लज्जा भी लगती है
एंड शेम आल्सो
दैट बहुत सारी चीजें एक साथ में
मेनी मेनी इमोशंस आर कमिंग हाउ
देयर आर प्रतिष्ठा की भावना भी रहती है
बट इन द सेम टाइम आल्सो डिजायर फॉर मटेरियल थिंग्स एज वेल एज नेम एंड फेम Who can I go in? Is there any Vaishnav? That I can go to someone without any duplicity? When will I become non-duplicious? And taking a straw in my teeth and take shelter of some Vaishnav and crying
गुरु महाराज जी की भाषा में दिखाने के लिए एक दिन के लिए थोड़ी देर के लिए केवल रोना
नॉट क्राइंग जस्ट
जोर जोर से चिल्लाना वो सब नहीं करके वास्तविक रूप में कब वैष्णवों का इस प्रकार से शरण लूंगा
व्हेन आई विल टेक द शेल्टर ऑफ द वैष्णवस
तो दामोदर महाराज जी बोल रहे थे दामोदर महाराज जी
व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन
अगर किसी को अपने हृदय की बात बताने भी जाओ
इफ यू गो टू टेल योर हार्ट टू एनीवन
जो दो दिन चार दिन दस दिन भी वैष्णव का संग करते हैं वो सीख लेते हैं और सभी को क्या कहते हैं कि नहीं नहीं आप तो दीनता कर रहे हैं
Then people say, "Oh, you're humble. You're being humble."
किंतु कहारे कहीं वो के बाद जाने मोर दुख
Who can I tell my real situation, my real distress to who I can? So these things come when I'm hearing the kirtan. That who can I go and tell my? Not taking too much
time.
Many senior devotees have. Many people have been speak
that.
I was not going to sit for Katha. Siddhanti Maharaj. Due to Maryada, is requested. Out of duty, asks me to speak
first.
One thing that I'm remembering of Srila Maharaj. Saying that I will, Maharaj used to say, those who worship Devi, when they worship Devi, when they speak to Devi, they are very polite. They sing stuff to Devi, they are very polite. And then, and they also fold their hands and also offer something to Devi.
Yeah. प्रणाम करना उपहार इत्यादि लेकर के आना ये सारा कुछ करके भी मन के भीतर ही भीतर में क्या करते हैं
But what do they doing? Even though externally they're doing many things, but in their mind, what?
बहुत बड़ी वस्तुएं मांगते हैं
They ask for many big things, many
वस्तुएं मांगते हैं इसके द्वारा
Through this,
and
through this asking for material things, that doesn't mean they are worshipers of Devi. Even though they speak very polite, they are not really polite. When they do pranam, it's not really pranam. Because in reality, because by speaking very sweet, they want to make Devi as a dasi so that she can fulfill others. They want something. Yes, give me wealth, give me fame. So they pray in this way inside their mind. But in reality, they want to make Devi their Dasi. Similarly, many they come into Guru, they come to Vaishnavas, Vaishnavas they come to Bhagwan. They speak very politely and offer pranam and bring many things for Thakurji and do many things. Amidas, Aminityadas. I will serve your lotus feet. I'll be so fortunate if I get yourself. They speak very politely. But what do they want?
अधिकांश लोग जिनके ऊपर वास्तविक निष्कपट कृपा नहीं होती,
most of them that don't have निष्कपट कृपा,
भगवान को अपने दास के रूप में नियुक्त करके ही प्रसन्न होते हैं।
They become pleased when they make Guru, Vaishnav and Bhagwan their das. But to do is offensive.
इसलिए
therefore, Maharaj used to say that Prabhu, Srila Maharaj used to say that never go with this mood to visit, to when you approach Guru, Vaishnavas and Bhagwan, never go with this consciousness to get something from it. Our Guru Maharaj used to say, Shila Bhakti Deita Madhav Goswami
Maharaj.
We become very happy by giving things. Many people think by getting things we will be very happy, but Bhakti Deita Madhav Goswami, from he used to teach us, Maharaj, from the beginning of our spiritual life, what teaching did he give us?
जो लाभवान होना उससे बहुत ऊंचा है।
That to give and to get give and happiness is more, much more than taking something from and being happy.
वैष्णव गुरु के भी जो आराध्य भगवान वो कैसी वाली वस्तु हैं?
Gurudev, Vaishnavas and they worship all the Bhagwan. They are those that by offering again and again to them, is one becomes more and well, becomes more successful, more happy, more profitable than to take from them. Indra is so polite to Vamandev. He offering pranam to Vamandev, offering, he is pressing the lotus feet of Vamandev, he is offering garlands, he is doing many things. Still, what is he doing? He is not a devotee, he is a karmi. Because in his heart, what is in his heart? By serving Bhagwan, I will become very, I'll always be the king of heaven, planets, and no one can defeat me, no one can take away my position. This chit, which is consciousness of a karmi. If one comes with this consciousness to Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas, he commits offenses. Even externally, he may be seeing something else. So it's very important not to have this in consciousness. When we come to Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas, we should always be there to engage in their service for their happiness. First, I will ask.
लोग सर्वप्रथम हमारे स्वतीर्थ गुरु भ्राता श्री पाद संजय कृष्ण प्रभु जी से कुछ पहले कथा श्रवण करेंगे, उसके पश्चात में हमारे श्री पाद सिद्धांति महाराज जी यहाँ पर उपस्थित हैं और श्री पाद भक्ति वेदांत श्रीधर महाराज जी के भी आने की हमारे को आशा है। तो
फर्स्ट वी लव संजय प्रभु, संजय कृष्ण प्रभु, देन सिद्धि महाराज, and then we are also expecting of Shripad Sridhar Maharaj to come.
सभी भक्त लोग जो यहाँ पर उपस्थित हुए हैं, मेरा सभी के चरण कमलों में प्रणाम।
All the devotees have come here. Oh, my pranam sir. To the Marjada, speak something. I've not offered my pranam sir. Offering forgiveness, sir. Offering forgiveness,
sir. हमारे बहुत प्राचीन वैष्णव श्रीपद रामचंद्र
प्रभु इज वेरी ओल्ड ड्यूटोरी हु इज फ्रॉम द अर्ली डेज
अपने प्रचार कथा के द्वारा
थ्रू हिज प्रीचिंग
गुरुदेव को
एंड मीटिंग गुरुदेव
हमारे जीवन में ला करके उपस्थित
एंड वी मेट गुरुदेव थ्रू हिम एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी एटर्नली इंडेटेड टू हिम बिकॉज वी केम टू गुरुदेव बिकॉज ऑफ हिम And all Vaishnavas, I'm doing my offering my pranams.
कृष्णा
हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
मैं सर्वप्रथम अपने परम आराध्यतम गुरुपाद पद
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ माय प्रणाम से
श्रील भक्ति
प्रणाम टू
भक्ति
नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज एंड देन टू एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ भक्ति विज्ञान भारती गोस्वामी महाराज इन द लोटस ऑफ सम ऑल द आचार्य गुरु परंपरा रूपानु गुरु एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ भक्ति सिद्धांत प्रभुपाद लोटस फीट नित्यानंद प्रभु महाप्रभु ऑल द एसोसिएट्स श्री श्री राधाकृष्ण पूज्य पाठ श्री भक्ति वेदांत सिद्धांति महाराज
पूज्य पाठ
शांत महाराज
पूज्य पाठ
रामचंद्र प्रभु विजय प्रभु
अन्य
वैष्णव महाराज शुभ तिरुभक्ति महोत्सव एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू योर क्वालिफिकेशन आई एम ऑफरिंग माय रिस्पेक्ट्स आई डोंट टेक टू मच देयर आर मेनी ओल्ड सीनियर वैष्णवस हियर ना पूज्य पाठ भक्ति वेदांत सिद्धांति महाराज जय भक्ति वेदांत श्रीधर महाराज हिस्काम
आगे आगे हो जाइए थोड़ा सा।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हमारी सभा में उपस्थित नैना सभा आप माधव प्रिय प्रभु जैसे आई फोर टू से वन थिंग सो जस्ट कम टू से समथिंग इन दैट कीर्तन आई तीन संसार मठ नरोत्तम दास ठाकुर इज वेल सेइंग दिस He said this, he's given this aim, this object, this goal to for the Ajat Rati, those who are not, those who are not pure Baddha Jeevs, by the mercy of Vaishnavas have come to, by Swami Maharaj, to, by met Puri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, that this happened very naturally for me, that I didn't have to make any endeavor. But I was not able, while hearing this Gita, I remember Param Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Goswami Maharaj, he was saying, when Prabhupada said, Narayana Seva Vigraha, they tried to explain to, they tried to teach me, they explained as many things possible to me. Whatever endeavor I could make, but there is no effect. How much I have to, they've given their time as much as possible, but did not change my heart. But Param Gurudev is saying, this is not changing my heart. But thinking me of disgusting, that even though we explained so many things to him, and explained to him, tried to, and endeavored for him, but nothing happened. That he did not, thinking of me very low, that I, they not, he's not accepting anything. And then Prabhupada, and they left me because they saw that I was so completely useless and that completely not taking the teachings, not so they left me. So similarly, I'm feeling the same thing, that even though very easily I've got the association of Vaishnavas, but still nothing happened. Nothing happened to me, that they have left.
Hare Krishna. Jaisa ki Prabhu ne apni katha mein bataya, aaj ek aur.
So Sanjay Prabhu is asking, today is very special day. So चलो ओके This is today is the disappearance of our Maharaj Srila Bhakti Vigyan Dutt Aarti Goswami Maharaj taking using on the auspicious the day that Haridas Thakur decided to live on the same tithi that Haridas Thakur left today also because of the today also the disappearance there is also appearance there Bhakti Vinod Thakur also all the teachings that what a Vaishnava has written that the appearance of Hari disappearance and appearance of Vaishnavas they are not ordinary today's appearance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, disappearance of Haridas Thakur and Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati was while hearing, listening to Mahadev Prabhu some Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada on the disappearance of Bhakti Vinod Thakur the consciousness where one feels separation from Gurudev is the foundation on which Sri Guru will appear. His real appearance will appear in the heart of one who is really feeling separation. Today is a meeting and disappearance of our Vaishnavas. In reality, appearance and disappearance. Vrindavan Das Thakur said, this is never, it is not their left, it is just in one Leela, they are going from one Leela to another Leela. It is just an interruption. Once one disciple, one time. I remember one while listening to Mahadev Prabhu, I remembered one thing. One time a disciple of Bhaktivinoda Swami Maharaj asked Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj in English. He asked, after Gurudev is how can the disciple always take advantage, and he had not finished his question. Then Sridhar Goswami Maharaj said, Bhakti Rakshak said, Guru is not limited. We must not put limitations. He is not within boundaries. On Guru Tattva we cannot.
गंभीर विचार विषय में बदलाया एक व्यापक विचार एक मार्गदर्शन गुरु और शिष्य के संबंध के विषय में श्री महाराज जी उत्तर देते हैं
महाराज जी सेइंग
जब भी हमने गुरु को एक आकार के रूप में देखा है
इवन द
गुरु इन अ फिगर
हम नो इवन द वी पुट गुरु इन अ फॉर्म एंड इन वैष्णव वी हैव सीन गुरु श्रीधर गोस्वामी महाराज He's saying same time. Krishna is said. He said in 11th Kirtan, Acharya Mam Vijayamiyam. Krishna, I am Acharya, I am Sakshat Guru. Guru is the Ashray Bhagwan. Even the external we see Bhagwan, Guru is one form. But Krishna is all vision. But Krishna says, I have come in the form of Guru. We should never forget this. We should never forget that Guru Krishna comes in the form of Guru, and the Guru is always eternal. If we are really interested in meeting Gurudev and serving Him and developing our heart, it is for sure. He will also reciprocate with me. If we really have developed love and interest in associating with Gurudev,
पदम का भी यही वास्तविक रूप में हमारे प्रति यही संबंध
The Gurudev will also reciprocate accordingly. That he is giving guarantee. It is not possible that Gurudev will not respect if one is bona fide disciple. How does he maintain his life? Give the example, Prabhupada. How did Prabhupada maintain his life? The Shridhar Goswami Maharaj. He said, he is searching for Shiva. He wrote one article that searching for Bhakti. How did Bhakti, Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Srila Prabhupada maintain it? Through in everything. Bhakti Prabhupada is saying, Bhakti Nath. He said, oh, Bhakti Nath, come, I didn't understand. There was another one disciple. One disciple took shelter of Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada and he was with him only for 2 days and then cried, 2 years and then stayed. And Prabhupada cried for him and he established a mud in his birthplace. He wrote an article about him. Bhagavad Jananand. Bhakti Raksha Siddhar Goswami is saying, and he expressed his mood. Srila Bhakti Nath Thakur in his form, but I could not understand. We have decided that Guru has come only in a special, in only one form, but Guru comes in many forms. Guru is not limited. If any disciple has realized who is knowledge, what is auspicious, who is auspicious for me and who is my well-wisher. If one is what is auspicious for me, who is my well-wisher, if one can understand, Guru will come in many forms and to help us, to assist us. Then he gave this example of this disciple of Prabhupada who saw Bhaktivinoda Thakur in many, many small incidences. Oh, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has come here, but I did not come in that form, but I did not realize that. It all depends on us. That Narottam Das Thakur, we are listening to the song of Bhakti Narottam Das Thakur. If we really interested in serving and serving Gurudev, in meeting Gurudev, then definitely for sure Krishna, Gurudev will come. When Yashoda Maya is crying for Krishna, when gopis are crying for Krishna, and other sakas are crying for Krishna, is it possible that Krishna, it is not, is it possible that Krishna will not respect it? And will it be possible that Krishna calls him? Is it possible that any associates will not appear? So therefore we should know what is auspicious for us and who is our well-wisher. And then Guru will appear in many forms. It all depends on our outlook, just like Narottam is saying, how his separation moods. Everything depends on Guru, on the disciple, how much love and affection for Gurudev, how much have we accepted Gurudev in our life. So while hearing Mother Prepa, I have seen. We have heard many times what Guru Maharaj has given Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, what he has given, no one else has given. It is true in one sense, but so can we say that no one else can give to us? You cannot get from anywhere else. The thing that Raghunath Das Goswami got from Sarup Dhamma, is it not possible that he cannot get from Rupa Goswami? What? Krishna Das Kaviraj did not meet with Mahaprabhu or Sarup Dhamma, that still he managed to get the thing. Therefore, when really understand these things, then we can understand how Gurudev comes in many forms. Nowadays everything depends external. If you take diksha, one takes mantra, then it becomes disciple. But reality is not depend on external things. It depends on what is accepted in the heart.
पति है ना कृष्ण उनके, किंतु कृष्ण उन्हीं द्वारका की महिषियों के सामने जिन ब्रज गोपियों के साथ उनका कोई ब्लड रिलेशन नहीं है, कोई संबंध नहीं है।
We see the queens are married to Krishna, so they have this relationship with Krishna. But then we hear in Vrijad Bhagavatam Ritam how Krishna is crying to the gopis, even though there is no relationship, no physical relationship with the gopis. Oh no. But in reality we see, even though externally we see that there is no relationship with the Braj, but still in reality we can understand the main relation. Therefore we Bhakti Rakshak Sri Krishna that he, why did Prabhupada used to say that everyone in front of me, all are my gurus? Once Gaurakishore Das Babaji warned Prabhupada, don't go to Calcutta. But then Prabhupada gave a whole class, why did I come to Calcutta? Because even though I'm staying in Gaudiya Math, and associating and seeing the devotees, seeing the seva vritti, seeing the inclination to perform service by the matvasis, I never feel that I am in material world. I'm not in Calcutta, but I'm in Mayapur. So Prabhupada, he saw Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in many, many forms. So he never felt like that I'm staying in Calcutta. Never. That I am not in the association of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, not in the association of Gaurakishore Das Babaji. Once we increase our adhikar, our qualification, then we'll always have darshan. Because relationship is not there. Like Narottam Das Thakur is crying. In the separation of Rupa Goswami, how much Raghunatha Goswami, today's Amar Chiti. One is final. On his last sutta, my Gurudev never saw faults in others. So I am following this. He is my identity, that I am following the adarsh, my conduct of my Gurudev. Even he said, I am sitting on a chair, even though I am taking, serving you by sitting on a chair. So his life was based on the conducts of his Guru Maharaj, Bhaktidaita Madhava Goswami Maharaj. I don't want to take too much time. There are many senior Vaishnavas, so praying Nishkapat, non-replacious Pratna, that I can understand this. Understand this internal relationship between Guru and Rab. Why did Maharaj accept the path? It's not a coincidence that Maharaj left on the same day as Haridas Thakur's Hiranya on the disciplines pastime. Only if they tell us, then we can understand. because Mahaprabhu Haridas Thakur also showed tolerance and his humility. So praying at the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati said that the relationship I can understand of guru and disciple as well, his conducts and teachings we can understand by praying for his mercy. We have heard from Pujya Padmadut and heard from Sanjay Prabhu. Had many little glories of Maharaj. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati told my our sthiti. What is our actual situation? And what is our protector? Who is our protector? Who can protect us? We think this is related to me, he will protect me. But in reality, besides Guru and Vaishnavas, in this world, there is not a well-wisher or a protector. There is no one. This is the essence. How can we understand? This is only by our bhajan and our seva. All of us cannot, not in the same level. Those who have experienced bhajan. What is but bhajan mean? What is the meaning of bhajan? The Gurudev seva. To make his mission your mission. Srila Maharaj. He said, Srila Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, that my Guru Maharaj, Bhakti Deit Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he is asking Srila Bhakti Deit Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he asked Srila Maharaj, who will be my successor? He asked many devotees, including Srila Bharati Maharaj, Bharati Goswami Maharaj. He said, Bharati Goswami Maharaj said, I don't have that much compassion towards living entities. That mood of feeling distress at the suffering of others. When acharyas speak like this, there is some teaching behind it. When we look at Jivan Charitra, we have a state. No. Maharaj does not speak anything lightly. So he always, there's always growth or some heaviness, some gravity to in his words, in his teachings. Srila Maharaj used to say, I never associated with light. That means I never associated those who are very light or non-serious. I always associated with those who are gravity, like our Guruji. Therefore, in his katha, in his words, ordinary, even in his joking, there are always teachings in that. And Maharaj used to speak very clearly. They've heard, he says very clearly that I heard this from so and so, I heard this from so and so. He used to take their names, he used to be very. And giving all credit to all his Gurujan, Guru Varga. Maharaj was very expert in a very sharp memory. He used to remember everyone's name. So whoever took his shelter, they knew. They know. Maharaj always speak what Srila Prabhupada or his Prabhupada's disciples. He always used to remember their teachings and their instructions. So when his Guru Maharaj asked him to become, what do you think about becoming acharya, he said, at that time he said that that compassion has not come in my heart to deliver the world, just like Prahlad Maharaj, who prayed that everyone should get bhakti. I'm not in that situation to be. So how can we understand this? So how can we understand this? Srila Maharaj used to say, the more high level association, naturally that much humility will come. This is not an ordinary thing, this is very deep. This is about the things you have heard now. This is due to stress sangha. When we heard from the earlier speakers, because of I've hardly associated. I used to do very little service, I used to come in now and then. I never really associated. Even though we've not got the association, physical association, but this is due to realization. Those who made Atma Sadhu, who made their heart one with other, their stress association will come through Vani. You can see how much association by your words. Even though you've not physically met, but how much have you taken their teachings in your because of the association, you can understand how much, because of how much high association. That's why he used to say, I never say anything like Diksha Kale Bhakta Karya Hatha. At the time of Diksha, he does Ashram. At the time when one takes Diksha, he got Atma San. Automatically, the more one surrenders to Guru at the time of Diksha, the more one becomes realized. There is one mantra. What? Mantra. Guru is not one figure, it is Akhanda Guru Tattva. We have to realize that. And when we realize this, then he doesn't have any difference, he doesn't see any difference between Siksha and Diksha. He realizes the importance of Guru, Siksha Guru and Diksha. Narottam Das Thakur initiation with Loknath Das Goswami, and then he did not take Diksha from Rup Goswami. But Narottam Das Thakur spent Loknath Goswami. He spent Loknath Das Goswami. Oh Gurudev, when will you take me with him and offer me at the lotus feet of Rup Goswami, Rup Manjari? Who is big, who is small? This is it. In the spiritual world, this is a different domain, this is a different chain that comes through realization, that comes through Guru Seva. Comes through Guru Seva and through Bhajan. And that is, to attain the Seva is through Bhajan. Otherwise, we'll just chant 16 rounds and attend program once a week. That is not enough. What is our realization? So Maharaj used to say, he used to give emphasis again and again, not on ordinary things, that we have to do things with what realization we are getting, what understanding we are getting by doing bhajan. Many more speakers are here. I will ask Pujya Pa Shant Maharaj to say something. message? First of all, offer my obeisance at lotus feet of Gurupad Shishyon. Pranams to all the Vaishnavas, and all the assembled Vaishnavas.
Also to Madhapapu Dandavat Pranam. Today we are present for the disappearance day, the Tirubhav Tithi. We are celebrating here at Radha Madhav Gauriya Math. And here, the very special, most worshipful Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj's disappearance day. In the scriptures, it said that Guru Vaishnav Bhagavan Tinar Smaran Hoy Vigya Vinashan. But very beautifully, our Madhav Priya Prabhu. He very beautifully displayed what was present in his heart in front of everybody. The very beautiful conceptions that the devotees have presented. When we speak about our relation with Krishna, Siddhanti Maharaj said in a similar manner, when we speak about gurus and guru and Vaishnavas, Vrindavan Das Thakur in Chaitanya Bhagavad is telling there's two samsaras. One is Nitya Samsara and one is Anitya Samsara. Nitya Samsara, wherever Bhagavan's service is going on, like in the Gaudiya Math, here whatever activity is going on is just for the objective of Bhagavan. In the Bhagavatam it is also said, it means the person who resides in the forest, he's doing a sattvic. He's residing in the mode of goodness. That person in in downtrodden places are in the mode of ignorance, and those in the city are in the mode of passion. But those in the temple are residing in the Mayavu. So when we come in the temple, it's a very beautiful creation. So therefore this has been told in Bhagavatam. So this relationship that we have with Guru is complete. In Guru, he connects us with Bhagavan. Atmasamarpan, Se Kale Krishna Kare, Atmasam. So that bhog, So this relationship with the Bhagavan Guru and Vaishnavas, how can that be complete? Chakshu Dhan Dido J, Jinme Jinme Pakase, Kipi Kanti De Pakashita. So that's the complete relationship, and this relationship with our family. This is anicca, this is the temporary relationship. Today we have a relationship, but it will change. Because we are traveling through 84 lakhs of species. In this manner, traveling through the 84,000 species of life, then Bhagavan gave this human birth. It is not for just simply enjoying, it is for performing Bhagavan's bhakti. So in the Bhagavatam it is told, so all the okay. So those persons who are Sukritivan, who are very pious, they will perform bhajan to Bhagavan. So Guru and Vaishnavas, when they come to this world, they come to give something. They don't come to take anything. So when they're here in this world, we don't manage to understand the value of the thing that they're giving. But once they go, then we can understand something of the value of the thing that they came to give. So in this manner, our mother and father in this world, they are also considered guru. It is a loka guru, meaning like a worldly guru. But then our paramarthic guru, our spiritual guru, our actual guru, he is the one who connects us with Krishna. So by all of your blessings, I have attained some association. Of Srila Maharaj, in his words, in his every statement, there was instructions, and very beautifully he would describe how we may increase in bhakti. And then speaking slokas from Shastra, even at such an advanced age, his memory of all of these slokas remained very sharp. So by performing bhakti, all of these things will continue to be made, continue to be had. And by the association of Vaishnavas, we are given a glimpse of this marg, of this path. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Narottam Das Thakur and the Bhagavatam have given these instructions. If we won't meet and have the association of Vaishnavas, then we won't be able to form bhajan and sadhan. So by staying near to our Gurujan and the Vaishnavas, we have someone who governs us, who chastises us, and thereby we are inclined to perform bhajan. So if we want to perform sadhana and bhajan, or we want to perform bhakti, then we need to do it under the guidance. Just by our mind's inclinations, our whimsical inclinations bhakti has not had. Guru is sarvatra, he is all pervasive. What is the difference between Guru and Vaishnava?
Guru sabhi Vaishnava gun parilakshit ho raha hai, wahi Guru pad lakshan.
In the Vaishnavas where all the symptoms of a Guru are present, then he is also called a Guru. So the path that the Guru and Vaishnavas have shown to us, the instructions that they have provided us, this eternal relationship which Gurudev has established, our eternal relationship with Guru and Vaishnavas, we take things quite lightly. We think, oh, I have taken diksha today, I did my mantras or I didn't do my mantras, it's just going forward. No, we don't actually know what Gurudev has done in the form of giving us Harinam. Why has he given this? He's given this in order for us to serve. So this service, under the guidance of Guru and Vaishnava, hearing and performing kirtan, when our service increases, then we ourselves will be able to realize, to experience, if our bhakti is increasing or not. This sloka, seva is by... it's for the affection of Guru and Vaishnava and Bhagavan. As Madhapriya Prabhu was saying, very, very beautiful, how the bhaktas of Devi, they speak very polite, they speak very sweet words, but then they are there to demand from her so many things. So therefore, Guru and Vaishnavas, they always take us under this path of Shuddha Bhakti. And here we need to continue to serve Guru and Vaishnavas. And in the Math Mandir, we should be careful to do all of these spiritual activities. So, Prabhupada said how this is a spiritual institute, this is a hospital. Therefore, we don't need to look at these trivial things which we see sometimes in the mat. But we should focus on our eternal relationship with Guru, Vaishnavas and Bhagavan. We know that our family is this Gora Parivar. Knowing this, we should increase, we should advance, progress. One time I had come with Madhav Maharaj and then Madhav Maharaj had asked to Srila Maharaj, what do we need to do on Ekadasi? And he said, Sri Hari Vasare Hari Kirtan Vidam. On the day of Ekadasi, we should do kirtan. So in this manner, he spoke very, very beautiful instructions. And I got the opportunity to touch the lotus feet. So I touched his lotus feet and they were so very soft. So to today I still have this memory. They were very, very soft, kind of like in the same way that Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, his lotus feet were so very soft. So having darshan of the Vaishnavas, attaining their mercy, we come for these things. And We have to see how much is our foundation, how much we are able to take. So the prayer is here that Maharaj may continue to be merciful upon us, and all of his katha and his teachings, we may bring them into our lives. And here I will end my katha. First of all, I offer my unlimited Satsang Dhanavad Pranams at the lotus feet of my most worshipful Guru Padma, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, and the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj from my heart, and under my unlimited Satsang Dhanavad Pranams. I am offering my Dhanavad Pranams to Srila Bhakti Vedanta Siddhanti Maharajji, Srila Maharajji, Shant Maharajji, to all of them, from my heart, my Dandavat Pranams. He's saying in my mind, I was thinking one thing, how Madhupriya mentioned that he didn't do Dandavats to me. So in Bhaktivinoda Thakur's Mangalati Sangha, there's this line, Vibhavari Shesh. In whose life they haven't attained Vibhavari Aloka Pravesh, they haven't entered that transcendental place, then they're lying down here, sleeping. So if you're lying, then you're doing Dandavat Pranams. So he's making a joke here. So who has attained Alok, who has attained transcendental abode? So one thing was overflowing in my heart that Maharaj Ji disappeared at this place, so this is like his samadhi place. He is eternally present here. So at this time, he is especially merciful.
शक्ति की बड़ी ही अत्यंत ही आवश्यकता है तो मैं वहाँ जाऊँगा उनको प्रणाम करके उनसे शक्ति
So and then he's very apt to provide his mercy, his potency. So therefore I have come here for this purpose, that I can pay pranams to his bhajan kutir and attain his potency. I haven't had so much dealings with him, but I haven't attained much association, so what may I say about him? What Mata Priyapu reminded me, kind of gave me some consciousness of. Mata Priyapu said that we have associated with so many Vaishnavas, but what have we managed to attain to take from that? He's saying we haven't taken the advantage of that, we have kind of squandered that opportunity, and then I'm sitting here, so what can I say? So we have one prayer that we may attain the association of Rasik Vaishnavas. So how can we attain that association of the Vaishnavas? And we need that type, that Rasik Vaishnava. But one very spoiled thing is that
क्या गड़बड़ बात हो जाती है और दिखते ही नहीं है रसिक वैष्णव
That we can't see a Rasik Vaishnava. When they go, we can't see them, and then it's like they've suddenly left from our grasp. As it was with Gurudev, Gurudev left. We didn't think that he would go so quickly. Traveling with him, sitting, eating, sleeping.
मन में कला नहीं होती है वो हॉस्पिटल में एडमिट हम थे कई बार हुए मैं वहाँ जाता था
When he was admitted into the hospital a few times.
देखभाल क्या करूँगा खाली हाल चाल पता कर देते और लोग बाग आलू के परांठे ले आते थे वहाँ बैठ के हम आलू के परांठे खाते
Someone would bring parathas, like he would eat the parathas in the hospital.
मैंने खास कर ये तो सेवा अपने गुरु भाई हैं और गुरु भाई हैं अब इनमें रसिक वैष्णव खोजो तो खोजते नहीं
So then searching amongst his godbrothers for a Rasik Vaishnava just like him, we couldn't find. So Gurudev said to associate with pure Rasik Vaishnavas. So we need to be inspired that we should find a Rasik Vaishnava, but then we're looking and saying, oh, maybe he's a Rasik Vaishnava, we should associate with him. Maybe he's a Rasik Vaishnava, we should associate with him. So when we meet a Vaishnava, we should be very happy. But that hasn't happened. So then, what Mata Priyapu said that I have done so much preaching. Then I'm just saying very small things. Pujapati Siddhanti Maharaj was saying. That I have preached so much. I'm saying, this is they're just saying this to encourage me, to enthuse me, so that I can do something. So Vijaypur is here, he's going to different devotees' house and speaking Harikata. This is called Utsaha, this is enthusiasm. I'm seeing in my life that Gurudev did preaching. Gurudev made the facility of preaching, and then I just enjoyed out off of that. So now I'm just enjoying Gurudev's empire. So what I've seen with the Vaishnavas, they don't think any particular good things for themselves, but they engage all these things in serving others.
Gurudev
said, associate with pure Sikh Vaishnavas, and towards them we should have such affection. So when we hear this, we think, how may I do? Our Param Gurudev wrote that in these tithis, discussing about the acharya, one's acharya, this is called sangha, association. So therefore today, I have come here to attain the association of the sangha. I have come here to attain that association of Nityalila Parvishtam Vishnu Parashtoto Sita Shishimad Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. I'm praying that he may give me his association, I may attain that, I may get the association of a Rasika Vaishnava. I may not demand more than this. So when it rains, the clouds do all the work. We just sit there and the rain comes. The clouds pour so much rain. So we're in the association of a Rasika Vaishnava. They just pour so much mercy. I remember so many days in Ambala when the program of the Bhumi Pujan for establishing the mat there was there with Srila Maharaj. They were going, taking Srila Maharaj from one place to another. I was there with Siddhanti Maharaj, with Madhapriya Prabhu. And I got the good fortune to hold his hand and move with him. And then I also got a photo there with him. And it's actually on the wall here at this mat. And I was feeling really, really proud that in this photo, my head was facing downward. My face was facing down. I stayed with Gurudev, I would massage him, I would hold his hands, I got his touch. And several years after, to touch the hand of Srila Bharati Goswami Maharaj, that very remembrance of my instance with Srila Gurudev came. So now that it has been told that Shiksha Guru, Diksha Guru, they are all one Akhanda Guru Tattva, one undivided principle of Sri Guru. They are all coming to us. They are teaching us that Guru is unlimited.
And in this form,
their speech is unlimited. There are so many Guru Vargas who we have heard from, who we have not heard from. If we get their touch, then it's such a good fortune. If we get their Sangha, it's even greater fortune. Madhapriya Prabhu said a very beautiful thing. There they don't have the system of taking anything. They come here just to give. But here in our world we have just this system of taking. If I'm doing some job, what is my salary going to be? If I'm looking for a girl to marry, then how beautiful will she be? If a woman is looking for a man to marry, then she's looking how much knowledgeable is he, how much money can he earn. So this concept of taking is constantly present. But these Guru Vargas, they come to give only. So Maharaj told his memories with Srila Gurudev, very beautiful memories. So 2, 3 I want to share with you. And we can remember these things. Maharaji says at one time I went to Sri Keshavji Gaudiya Math in Mathura because it was Nityadeva Prishtam Vishnupad Ashtata Sata Sri Shriman Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj's Tirobha festival, so I was invited. So I went there. And who gave me that invitation? It was our worshipful Gurudev, Nityadeva Prishtam Vishnupad Ashtata Sata Sri Shriman Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. So he invited and I came and I sat with him. We had Hari Katha and then he saw to all the prasad arrangements. He said, come and sit in everyone on our prasad. So, Gurudev said, I will serve and then I will take prasad with you. And then they both sat together, Gurudev and Srila Maharaj. And then at that time, when they sat to honor prasad, one disciple of Srila Prabhupada arrived. Pujapad Srila Bhakti Prapanna Damodar Goswami Maharaj. Who had also accompanied us one time for Braj Mandala Parikrama. So he came and he is a senior. So Gurudev said to Srila Maharaj, you take prasad, I will take after. Then he said, no, I will wait for you. And then they told this Srila Bhakti Prapanna Damodar Goswami Maharaj, you come and sit and take prasad. He said, yes, I will take, but first I will take bath. So he took bath. Then he came and he took prasad. Then after that, Gurudev came and he took honored prasad with Srila Maharaj. So then we got the teaching from this that first serve the Vaishnavas prasad, feed them to their satisfaction, and then honor prasad yourselves. One very beautiful memory. Maharaj ji is saying, in Vishakhapatnam, for the establishing of a mat, we had gone. There was an opening of a mat, and we had gone there for that celebration. The mat of Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami Maharaj. At that place, Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj had also come. Madhav Maharaj, I don't know if Madhav Maharaj is there either. So at that time, Gurudev's health was not good. So from there he had come to Puri. And in Puri, Srila Maharaj has his permanent place, Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math. So that Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math is right there on the grand road near to Jagannath Mandir. and that is the appearance place of Srila Prabhupada. So that is the mat there. So our Gurudev had forbid that, oh, I will not go, because there is such a crowd, and at our Nidachal Gaudiya Math, there's not such facilities where I can manage. So Srila Maharaj said, you come to Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math and I will give you a separate room with an attached bathroom.
तो मैंने बिना बताए एक दिन पहले की टिकट करा ली ट्रेन की और निकल गया जबकि मेरी टिकट
So without telling anyone, Srila Maharaj had booked a ticket a day before their scheduled program to go, and he had went to Puri. So one day before, he went back to Puri and he completely emptied his own room, which had an attached bathroom, and kept all of his belongings in a separate room. And then when Srila Gurudev came, he provided him with that room, not telling that that was his own room. So he goes early, he empties his room, and he tells him, after inviting him, he gives him this room, not telling him that it's his own room. So this is Vaishnava etiquette. Without telling the other, I'm just giving everything. Seeing the pastimes which take place between the Vaishnavas, I become very blissful, very happy. So this is an old thing, maybe 7 many years ago. So Gurudev had gone to Raja. When Gurudev had stayed at Govardhan, he had a very small room at this place of the Govardhan Math. Our Giridhari Pandit, he would also describe this. And then just becoming very immersed, Srila Gurudev would perform bhajan. And he was saying that I want to just dive deep into these conceptions of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he requested Srila Maharaj certain granthas that he could not attain there, such as Ujjvala Nilamani or Gira Samrita Sindhu. So Srila Maharaj searched so much in Calcutta, and these were out of print, but somewhere or another he found them in second hand, and he attained those granthas. And then Gurudev, he remained so interested in deeply studying all of these conceptions and how he stayed continuously engaged in that. And Srila Maharaj, he never said, oh, it's out of print, it's not available, I can't get them, I couldn't find them. He never said that. He worked so hard to find those granthas, to attain them, and to give them to Srila Gurudev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Then in the end, I tell you one more thing.
शुरू शुरू में जब गुरुदेव मथुरा में शिफ्ट हुए
in the beginning when Gurudev, Arshila Gurudev, had shifted from to Mathura from Bengal. So there, his health didn't remain good. Srila Maharaj said, I went there to meet him in that, at the mart in Mathura. And I said, you should travel all throughout the North India preaching because your Hindi is so nice. So where can one find such a Rasi Vaishnava who is also speaking the Hindi language so proficiently? So Gurudev said, I want to do this also, I want to preach, but my body is just not cooperating with me. So then Srila Maharaj took him to one Ayurvedic doctor who was there in Kolkata and who gave so much respect to Vaishnavas. For the normal people, there was a line they would have to stand in for an hour or so, but when he saw a Vaishnava, he would immediately take them and see them. So then Gurudev took this advice from the doctor, and then his health became better and he was able to go and preach all over the world. So this type of praying that we see amongst these Vaishnavas, this type of praying in this Tribhuvan, this world, it's nowhere to be seen.
लेकिन स्ट्राइकर एक मारता है ठान करता है और सारी गोटियाँ जो है वो अलग अलग हो जाती हैं. ये है, हम लोग एक परिवार में ऐसे गोटियाँ मिली हुई हैं और काल का स्ट्राइकर आके ठान मारता है और हम सब क्या हो जाते हैं, अलग हो जाते हैं.
वैष्णव में भी ऐसा हो जाता है. One family, we see in this world how all the people of one family, then something happens and then they all scatter to different places. So amongst the Vaishnava, it's also like this. We have to remain like this in this world. Who is mine? Krishna says that all these jivas, they are my amsh, my parts and parcels. So, other than Guru and Vaishnavas, there is no one who is ours. So we are just moving throughout this world, attaining the results of our previous activities.
आपके चरणों में है ये मेरी अर्जी कि आपकी मर्जी में रहे मेरी मर्जी. आपके चरणों में है ये मेरी अर्जी.
I'm praying that
आपकी मर्जी में रहे मेरी अर्जी और आपके चरणों में ये इल्तजा, ये उर्दू का शब्द है.
He's speaking something a bit poetic, praying that
इल्तजा
at your feet, if it's your desire that I can stay, then it's my
आपकी रजा में मिले मुझे मजा. रजा समझते हो? रजा मैंने आपकी मर्जी, आपकी मर्जी में रहे मुझे मर्जी नहीं, उससे भी काम नहीं चलेगा. जो आपकी मर्जी है उसमें मुझे क्या मिले, मजा. करता मैं इसका उल्टा हूँ, होता मेरे संग उल्टा है. जो वो मेरे संग करते हैं मैं उससे घबराता हूँ, डरता हूँ, रोता हूँ, चीखता हूँ, चिल्लाता हूँ, पड़िए बजाओ. लेकिन प्रार्थना ये करता हूँ आपके चरणों में ये इंतजार.
Prayers that I may attain the dust of your lotus feet. That Vaishnava's potency, which I myself cannot earn or acquire, I may attain that.
Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। मैं सबसे पहले अपने गुरु पाद पर नित्य लीला प्रभु श्री विष्णु पाद
I pay my unmerited satsang dandavat pranam to the lotus feet of my most worshipful Guru Padma Tidila Pavishnam Parivajakacharya Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, and thereafter to Tidila Pavishnam Vishnu Parash Dr. Sri Srimad Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, I offer my unlimited dandavat pranams and pay for his process mercy. And to all the Vaishnavas, my dandavat pranams. To Sri Bhakti Vedanta Sri Ramaraj, Sri Bhakti Vedanta Siddhanti Maharaj, Puchipad Bhakti Vedanta Sant Maharaj, Sri Ramachandra Prabhu, Puchipad Sri Madhupe Prabhu, Puchipad Vijay Krishna Prabhu, Sanjay Prabhu, all the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. To as per their qualification, my dandavat pranams to all the Vaishnavas. So we are so very fortunate that we're here at the place of Maharaj's disappearance. We are here sitting together and we are hearing of the divine character of Srila Maharaj. And today is a day where there's many appearance and disappearance days of Vaishnavas. Srila Haridas Thakur's disappearance day, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur's appearance day, and Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj's disappearance day. So the Vaishnavas tithis, whether it is the appearance or the disappearance, both are supremely auspicious for the jivas. And this disappearance tithi particularly, it is even more beneficial. Nityalila Pravishnam Vishnu Parash Tadasata Shishimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj saying once somewhere that what does this disappearance tithi do? This path that has been covered, it sheds light on that path. And then who is surrendered, who has served the Guru, then this viraha is provided to him, and within his chitta, within his heart, it gives the manifestation of the teachings of the Guru. So one who is surrendered, one who is for all these different types of devotees, disciples, it gives auspiciousness, but particularly for the surrendered disciple. So for the surrendered disciple, it gives each activity of the Guru, how he would compose granthas, how he would do bhajan, all of these things become manifest in the heart of that disciple, that disciple who has truly served. So under that disciple's guidance, we need to celebrate the disappearance tithi of our Guru Padpatna. So if we may just have darshan of one of these tears that comes from the eyes of such a devotee, then we are just so auspicious, so fortunate. So I tried to touch something on the divine character of Srila Maharajji, as Ramachandra Prabhu was just saying, how he served. If we look at the character of Srila Maharaj, so there's so many ideals for grihasthas, for brahmacharis, for sannyasis. Maharaj again and again said, Nitalila Prabhushtam Vishnupad Ashtota Satishishimad Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj said that we have two worshipable objects, Vishnu and Vaishnavas. We need to serve both of them. But if we have to choose just to serve one, then I would choose to serve the Vaishnavas. Because Vishnu's service is everywhere. We can establish Vigraha in the house and serve. But not everywhere can we attain the association of Vaishnavas. So if I can choose one, I will choose the service of the Vaishnavas. And in order to serve the Vaishnavas, if I have to take a loan, then I will take that loan and I will serve them. And then in order to pay off that debt, if I have to take another birth, then I will take that birth, and then in that birth I will also serve the Vaishnavas. So Vaishnava service is our life. So in the process of how to serve the Vaishnavas, Maharaj related, spoke so many things. So as Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj had said, I want to go to Puri, but there's such a crowd at Neelachal and there's not proper facilities, so I can't go. And how Srila Maharaj knew that if he told Srila Gurudev that he would go and empty his own room and give that, he would be hesitant to go. So one time, Sri Chaitanya Kodimat, the Mool Math in Vrindavan, there was a establishing of the deity. So Srila Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj said, in Navadvip, he said to give invitations to all the senior Vaishnavas within Navadvip. So before there was no phone, so how was the invitation given? It was go to that Vaishnava, pay pranams, and bring them. So Srila Maharaj was seeing all the arrangements in Vrindavan, and he took a train to Navadvip and gave invitation to all the disciples of Srila Prabhupada. Then all of these Vaishnavas became prepared to go for the festival. And then Srila Bhakti Vichayayi Vargasaraj was not able to go, so there was an extra ticket. And then when Maharaj said, was asked if there's an extra ticket, he said yes. And then he told that Vaishnava, your seat is here, took him to the seat. Then on the whole train, which was 20 hours or so, he was awake the whole night serving these Vaishnavas. And then one Vaishnava noticed that, oh, this was not my seat, but actually Srila Maharaj, he had given his own seat. So how to serve the Vaishnavas? In Maharaj's life, there are so many instances where he displays how we are to serve the Vaishnavas. So then there's a slok in the Bhagavatam how we should serve the Vaishnavas by mind, body, and words. If we can't do it by mind, then we should do it by words. If we can't do it by words, we should do it by body. But we should do that. So in the year 2016, Maharaj came in Kartik to Vrindavan, and I saw him, and he would always give prasad. He would often give Jagannath prasad, peda. So in Kartik, there were so many devotees from abroad, from local, who came to meet Srila Maharaj. So it doesn't matter if 2 people came, if 10 people came, if 150 people came. Maharaj would serve everyone prasad from his own hand. His age was very advanced. So then Mata people told him how we will just serve them, you can just touch it with your hand. Prabhupada was looking at me, and Maharaj many times requested. But Maharaj was saying, I've become old now. In my young age, I was able to do so much service, and now I'm not able to do that service. I can't take the bucket and serve Prashad. But at least Bhagavan has given me this much capacity that I can just give each devotee one cup of Prashad. So his whole life was spent in service. There's so many examples how the mandir was about to be established and they had to keep the chakra on the top. So there wasn't proper scaffolding for properly climbing the mandir to put the chakra. But still he went and he said how if I'm to like lose my life while doing Vaishnava Seva, then what's the harm? He was like fearless. Nitalila Pivishta, Shindla Bhakti Rakshak Shira Goswami Maharaj, Nitalila Pivishta, Shindla Bhakti Gyankesha Goswami Maharaj, Nitalila Pivishta, Shindla Bhakti Yarivar Goswami Maharaj. So many surrender disciples of Srila Prabhupada, he served them and received these mantras from them, these instructions in the form of mantras. Because he served them. He served them and he received this mantra. So we don't have this type of separation mood for the Vaishnavas. Therefore, we're not able to serve them and have this attainment, this understanding, this entrance into the moods of Srila Maharaj. So the prayer is that one drop of this may manifest in my heart of his moods and his service. So many things, all the previous devotees are saying. There's so many things to be spoken. But there's so many people to offer Pushpanjali to the lotus feet of Srila Maharaj. So in this sequence, I am asking Ambarish Prabhu to speak. He is a disciple of Srila Maharaj. He and his wife Lavanga Didi. Not only do they, not only Srila Maharaj's, but Srila Gurudev's, day and night, they give so much energy and so much work on preserving Srila Gurudev's Harikatha and Srila Maharaj's Harikatha. With the audio saver. I was asking Maharaj if I could speak in English, but he said no, you should speak in English because everyone present sitting is Hindi speaking except for me. So I will speak in some Hindi and in some English. I remember one thing. On the occasion of his disappearance,
Guru Maharaj's
on the occasion of his disappearance, so many things have been spoken. I didn't get the opportunity to spend so much time with Guru Maharaj during his physical presence. But about after 1 year after his disappearance, Tithi, after he manifested his disappearance, such an assembly happened in Vrindavan, where the Sabhapati had said that Pujapad Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, after his disappearance, an extraordinary league of devotees, a whole generation of devotees has now become unmanifest. This type of service inclination that they have, this ideal that we got to see, now we are not able to see that. As Madhupriyapu in his offering, he said, there's so many remembrances are there. What did Guru Maharaj say? He said, how can we recognize a pranayi bhakta, that bhakta who has that love and affection for Bhagavan? So as long as we are not sincere, as long as we are not surrendered, we won't understand truly who is a pranayi bhakta. We may even remain in his association, remain close to him, but his subtle conceptions, his deep hidden moods, these will not touch us if we are not sincere or surrendered. So Guru Maharaj explained this point in a very eloquent, very simple language. So the meaning of the word sincerity, who can see what is sin and what is piety. That's the general meaning of sincere. But what Guru Maharaj would explain, would say, other than the desire to attain Krishna, if there's any other desire in the heart, then that person cannot be called sincere. And he also described the meaning of the word sharanagat, surrendered. Who can be called sharanagat, surrendered? Who, every time any service is present, he is prepared, he is ready, he is willing to do that, eager to do that. And if we can combine sincerity and surrender, if we can combine these two qualities, so to whatever degree those are present in us, to that degree we will be able to recognize a pranayi bhakta, that devotee who has such affection for Bhagavan. So the mercy of such pranayi bhaktas is not manifest at a place where there is any lacking in one's surrender. At that place, their mercy is not present. So say there's one person who's a pranayi bhakta, and there's another who is trying to show that he's a pranayi bhakta. Then in the pranayi bhakta, however many qualities are present, all of these qualities, the other one who is not actually pranayi bhakta, he is trying to display that all of these qualities are present in him.
Above all,
So if we don't have entrance into the Shastras, if we're not sincere, if we're not surrendered, then that person who's not a Pranayi Bhakta but is displaying himself as such, we will accept him as a Pranayi Bhakta. And then who is actually a Pranayi Bhakta, he will never try, he will never endeavor to manifest his divine qualities. When after I had taken Diksha, I went to meet with one very, very senior disciple of Srila Swami Maharaj, who I was in contact with quite some time, and I told him that I've taken shelter of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. And he said to me, naturally to me, do you know how, like in an unassuming manner, he said, do you know what a great personality your Guru Maharaj is? Such a superior, such a topmost Vaishnava. Being in his institution for over 60 years. And then under his shadow, he served his Guru Maharaj, not in the limelight, but kind of behind the scenes. So for a conditioned soul to do that type of conduct as he did, it's not possible. Because the conditioned soul has some type of desire that just shows, you know, who he is. So all the time we endeavor for these things like worldly gain, worship, adoration. And one other thing Sripad Sanjay Prabhu was saying about Srila Bhakti Rakshak, Pujapad Bhakti Rakshak, Srila Goswami Maharaj. There's one very captivating grantha, Sri Guru and His Grace, about form and the essence, as Sanjay Prabhu was saying. How we address that this is my Guru as to one particular form. And the fact that Guru is a principle. Serving Sri Guru, hearing from Sri Guru, the enthusiasm, the bliss, the inspiration that we should serve Krishna, that we should abandon our worldly desires. If that is coming into our heart from another Vaishnava, then that is also your Guru's manifest presence there. And I accept it as our good fortune that, as we came here, Guru Maharaj's Acharya Leela, I only had about 1 to 1.5 years with him. Physically near to him. And I had mentioned in one of my offerings before that it's like before we got a chance to really associate with him, he was pulled from our association. So then before Diksha, those 3-4 years when I got the opportunity to hear something from him. So Gurudev's manifestation is compared to a moonbeam, very soft, very sweet. But after Guru's disappearance, as the blazing rays of the sun, we experience that. But Gurudev said that both have their speciality. In the manifest presence of Gurudev, when we are residing near with him, then in our heart, a very great wealth is slowly being placed in our heart. And then in the unmanifest presence of Sri Guru, as the blazing rays of the sun manifest as the separation, whatever Gurudev has kept in our heart, his true wealth, he begins to show that. So all the time it begins to occur to us that if Gurudev was physically manifest, that would be nice. Shri A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, over a year before his disappearance, a letter was sent to all the centers saying the Acharya may be disappearing, so whoever wants to come should come. This was near to the time when he was to disappear. So they sent the letter, it's near to the time where he will not remain in this world for much longer, he will be disappearing from this world. And then these very superior sannyasis, they just weeping and weeping, they came near to Sri Swami Maharaj. In one particular sannyasi, Srila Swami Maharaj said, "What do you want to say?" And he's saying, we learned so much from you, but we didn't learn so much that we managed to stand on our own two feet. So he said, will you stay longer? Then Srila Swami Prabhupada said a very deep statement. You learn many lessons during my presence, but there are some lessons which will be learned only by my departure. And Guru Maharaj would say, especially how Srila Siddhanti Maharaj expect his regret to Srila Maharaj, how I'm always traveling and preaching, so I can't stay physically with you as Madhav Pribhus and serve you. And Guru Maharaj described how the peacock is not until only when the rain cloud shows, then he begins to dance. And the example of the sun and the lotus, how they are related. No matter how great a distance they are from each other, they are related intimately. So, Guru Maharaj stressed a lot that by relation there is affection, priti. Asheshmate man magana hoido, Vaishnavete desha matarati na janmilo. And this kirtan is being stated that in my mind all the time this me and mine, this my own personal desire is present. And if just even in a very small degree for the satisfaction of the Vaishnavas, we may give our energy, then to that degree our affection may arise towards him. And our auspiciousness will be awakened in our life. And I just want to say one more thing and complete my speaking here. There are still more speakers to hear from. So when we came into the close contact of our Guru Maharaj, we understood that it's not so easy. Then I'm able to say that the devotees from Western countries, even us who understand Hindi, we are so grateful for Madhav Priya Prabhu to be able to understand Srila Maharaj. And through his service inclination, his surrender, how our Guru Maharaj became so pleased, and all the things that he was able to distribute. So we feel very indebted to him. So I was saying to him how on Zoom there's so many nice memories going. And he's saying, but being here and hearing all these things and being in the with all these Vaishnavas and hearing all these things on Zoom, it's like such a great difference. Not that the Zoom thing is any less, but this type of environment. And 4 years before, where this very place where our Guru Maharaj had manifested his disappearance lila 4 years before. As soon as the kirtan started, this that atmosphere, the experience of that atmosphere is had. But as Madhav Priya Prabhu had stated, Jayani Nupimudan Prasanna, we don't manage to have this type of separation. And Pujapad Srila Bhakti Vedanta Trivikram Goswami Maharaj, as he said during the time of Parikrama, I'm doing Parikrama from so many years, but it occurs to me that I haven't gained anything. And Gurudev Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, understanding the moods of his heart, our Guru Maharaj was also present there. Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj asked him to speak a few words, and Guru Maharaj said how this is a manifestation of his humility. So many people also made it clear that our situation So one thing is for sure, that when there's some experience in the heart, then truly this humility is expressed. Shripad Madhav Priya Prabhu, Shripad Sanjay Prabhu, Shripad Bhakti Vedanta Siddhanti Maharaj, Srinartam Prabhu, how they did such antaranga, such intimate service to our Guru Maharaj in their heart, on this chiti, what moods, what of our Guru Maharaj's conceptions are present, the experience of separation from our Guru Maharaj, by all of this, this atmosphere of separation is made. So here I am ending my speech. So many things, but it's very difficult to stop the mind. And we have also indication that Maharaj is present and he needs to go, and there's also going to be some delay in Prashad, so I don't want to speak more. I will just request Sri Vijay Prabhu that he may speak something. My dandavats to my Guru Maharaj, my dandavats to Srila Bharati Goswami Maharaj, to all the Vaishnavas. I'm not going to take so much time, so I will tell everything in brief. So, worshipful Srila Maharaj, so from his disappearance, 4 years have passed. I remember that Pujapad Madhav Priya Prabhu, so Madhav Priya Prabhu had taken Srila Maharaj to Jammu, where I was staying, and around. He stayed for about 10 years. I got the opportunity to serve him.
सुंदर समझा प्राप्त हुआ जो हम लोग सुबह से जो सुन रहे हैं अभी बड़ी सुंदर सुंदर
सो व्हाट वी आर हियरिंग फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग
तो सब बात सुन के यही समझ आया
From all of these things, it, I'm understanding from what Bhakti Vinod Thakur has said. He said that Ekakiyama nahi paibal harinam sankirtane Tumi kripa kori shraddha bindu diya Deo Krishna nama dane Krishna se tomar Krishna dite paro Tomara shakti ache Amito khan gav Krishna Krishna boli Dai tava pache pache So this is the essence of all of these things That we've been hearing So when the Vaishnava leaves Then we get to understand more of his glories So that something, some opportunity has left us. Bhakti Vinod Thakur has also written, this is the world of this rule. When something is present, we don't manage to understand its value. But when something leaves, then we understand something of its value. So this is a rule of this world. So at this time when we are present, we didn't understand much, but then when he left, then we began to understand something. So I just want to say one or two things. This Vishuddha Chaitanya Vani WhatsApp group, which keeps sending so much Harikatha, I look there, I read something also. And I see what is Srila Maharaj's perspective. However many disciples there are of Srila Prabhupada, I've heard their names, but I don't know so many details. But when I saw Srila Maharaj, So in a special manner, Srila Maharaj, he remembered each of these disciples of Prabhupada, each of their qualities. And from that quality, what instruction we are to take, that also he remembered and he told. So if we are to become saragrahi, if we are to accept the essence of this thing, this is no joke, this is not a small thing. The Sargrahi Vaishnav, that Vaishnav who is able to accept only the essence, he sees the essence of others. He can see that in others and he can take that. Seeing the essence and taking the essence, he is capable to do that. And all the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, from each of them, he is able to see all of these qualities in them. So, being near to Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Gosvami Maharaj, we got to see all these things, learn all these things, and then nowadays, even when we read about all these Vaishnavas, it is still appearing, seeming to us to be newer and newer. So, such details, such small things are also there. And then Maharaj, he had given all of these instructions. So then we're also hearing about viraha tattva, separation tattva. Separation, milan and viraha, meeting and separation. So if in his separation we're able to remember his life, his character, his teachings, in the manner that we are hearing, as we heard about with his interactions with Srila Gurudev, how he did Vaishnava's service, how Gurudev would invite him for Srila Rupa Goswami's conference, serving and seeing qualities and remembering that and giving also the instructions of others. This is not an ordinary thing. So at the time of his separation, all of these things, maybe we be able to take all of these things, all of these deep instructions and teachings that he gave. Param Pujya Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, seeing how Srila Maharaj was accustomed to his Brahminical samskaras to not sit with all the devotees and honor prasad, so how many years he made arrangements to serve him from devotees born from Brahmin families. So from his character here, I also got so many teachings. For one to change themselves, for one to really change, it takes a lot of time. We want everything to be done so fast. We want just in a few days I can get nishta and ruchi and bhav and prem. Then 2 days we want to become a manjari, and then in a few more days we become completely crazy. So, to change someone's impressions, one's samskaras, one's nature, one's swabhav, this takes such a long time. And the Vaishnavas, how patient they are in this, as a mother and father. So, when we're a child, also we don't know what the mother and father, what everything the mother and father do for us. But when we become older, we begin to understand something. So then, when they go, when we become older, then we understand what they've done for us. In order to improve me, what he has done. So I won't take much more time. I just pray at the feet of Srila Maharaj. When there was the mat there in sector 14, I was there with Ajit Prabhu and others, and Maharaj's health was not good. But still, we ask a question, and how can we attain our auspiciousness? And he said how we have to become sincere. From sincerity, all the obstacles go away. And sincere means nishkapat, means non-duplicitous, without this cheating proclivity. So my prayer at his lotus feet is that I can become nishkapat, I can become non-duplicitous. And this mood to serve the Vaishnavas may awaken in my heart. Srila Bhakti began by Tirtha Maharaj Ki Jai, Srila Haridas Thakur Ki Jai, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur Ki Jai, Gaura Premanand.
चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय यैस्तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः श्रीकृष्णचैतन्यप्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैतगदाधर श्रीवसति गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
सर्वप्रथम
First of all, to the lotus feet of my Guru Pad Padma, Nityali Lapavishtam Vishnu Parashtuta Satashi Shima Bhakti Shirup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, after my unlimited Sajstam Dandavat Pranams, and my Shiksha Guru Pad Padma. Ichadi Lapavishtam Vishnu Parashtuta Satashi Shima Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. And in Ichadi Lapavishtam Vishnu Parashtuta Satashi Shima Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. To the lotus feet, I offer my faithful Pushpanjali to Shripad Siddhanti Maharaj, Shripad Shant Maharaj, and Maharaj Pirpabhu, all the devotees sitting on the stage, and to all the devotees, I offer my pranam. Today is our very fortunate day. It is the grand festival of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj's disappearance day. So we have all come present here for this event. So Bhagavan says, Janma Karma Chame Divyam. Krishna is saying, Arjuna, my birth and activities are divine and transcendental. If one truly understands them, then once he leaves this body, he will not have to take another birth. So Vaishnava also not Janma Karma Bandhanam. Vaishnavas also don't have the bondage of birth and activities within the material world. They're not bound by those things. By the desire of Bhagavan, they come into this world, and by the desire of Bhagavan, they leave this world. But the Tirubhav, the disappearance day, it has its particular importance. So the Chiti, the appearance day of Bhagavan, Krishna, Ram, etc., it only comes once in a year. But that of the Vaishnava, it comes twice a year. Dhruva Maharaj, he kept his feet on the head of death personified and went to Vaikunth. In the same way, the Vaishnavas, in their very body, they can conquer this material world and just leave. Jitpu was saying how Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj said how the particular benefit of the Tirubhav. The Vaishnavas mercifully leave their disappearance here in the world, and they leave so that these instructions that they have left, we may adopt those. So, how is Krishna's Tirubhav? Vishwanath Chakravarti Katha Kaur said,
जो उसकी पत्नी को दे दिया इतने में उसका दो बच्चे थे उनने एक साथ में दोनों बच्चे झपट करके वो हार को पकड़ लिया एक कहता है मुझे चाहिए दूसरे कहता है मुझे चाहिए अभी कोई छोड़ने के लिए
सो ही इज टेलिंग द स्टोरी ऑफ वन म्यूजिशियन How a musician did a very extensive magician. He did a very extensive act of magic because he was such an expert magician. He
उसका जो पति था पर जो पत्नी बच्चे ही नहीं रहे थे मैं क्या करूं
Something how, anyway, this magician did a very extensive act of magic where he had like cut someone's head off with a sword and then later showed that he was, this was in front of a king, he was doing it.
हमें तो पहला उपहार उन्होंने गजपति हार दिया लेकिन लाज पे जो हमने जादू विद्या दिखाई हाथ की सफाई अभी तक तो उसका कोई इनाम हमें मिला है हम कोई मरे अभी हमारी ये एड्रेस है
So, that magician sent a letter to the king saying, even though externally that he didn't give us the reward for our second act, then the king, he saw the letter, he said, then the king and queen went to see where the magician said he was, then he saw the magician, his wife and his two sons are still present, and then the king saw, he gave them the gift for the second act. So Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur is saying, if an ordinary magician can show acts like this, what to speak about Vaishnavas on whose heart Bhagwan is present? Bhagwan himself is, I'm the heart of devotees and devotees are in my heart. Bhagwan is saying in Durvasa Rishi, Narayan said, I am in the heart of my devotees and devotees are in my heart, so therefore no devotees are... Then Krishna also said this to Uddhava, that devotees are not more dear to me than my own brother. My brother Balram or my queen or Lakshmi or Brahma or Shiv, the devotees are so much dear to me than all of them. They are my life. In Tattva, Srila Bharti Goswami Maharaj has never left this place. Just like a baby, a father is teaching a baby, a child, small baby, he's holding the hand and teaching and making it walk. But as the boy grows up, and slowly they let go of that hand and they watch from behind and they watch, let him walk on his own. And similarly, Vaishnavas have not left. They are always here. They are here. But they want to see. Mother Prabhupada. Like a Param Gurudev wrote, that Prabhupada gave to me, but they left that. So similarly, Srila Bharti Goswami Maharaj says, okay, what I have taught you, how much are you following? So in Vaishnavas, in Tattva, they have no place. That's why for Vaishnavas, we don't say die. We say Virha Mahotsav. In this world, when ordinary people die, everyone is sad. But Vaishnavas, we say Mahotsav. Why do you celebrate a festival? Because they have come from Golok Vrindavan to fulfill the order of Mahaprabhu, Radha Govinda, and to preach their mission, their teachings. So when they come here, they can believe unlimited. That jeev who is trapped by Maya, if Prabhupada said, if somehow one can engage one jeev in bhakti, is better than building millions of hospitals and schools. So there's nothing compared to delivering a jiva, compared to jiva to engage in bhakti, than compared to building hospitals and schools. Similarly, Srila Bharti Goswami Maharaj, he engaged, helped so many jivas in engaging in bhakti. So when he goes to Golabrinda, in this world is Viraha, but when he in that world, that time Radha Krishna and Mahaprabhu, they give so much happiness, they welcome him because he has helped so many jivas in engaged bhakti. Therefore Vaishnavas, we don't say die, we say Viraha Mahotsav. In Tattva Maharaj is left here. Tattva is he present here. So the Mahabhagavats in Kunti Devi is saying, what are the three obstacles to bhakti? Janma, Aishwarya. Janma means birth. Aishwarya means wealth. Education and beauty. Just one quality brings so much pride in a person. Even get one quality cannot do Bhagavad Bhajan. But if you think this Mahapurush had these four qualities in Purva Bengal. He took birth in West.
When Mahaprabhu was leaving,
he left Prem in a river called Prem in Padma River. So when Mahapurush comes, you give this Prem. So the river is saying, how do I know this is Mahapurush? He said, then Mahaprabhu said, when he touches you, when he enters your waters, then you'll know he's a Mahapurush. Narottam Das Thakur, by touching of his foot, the river started boiling over itself. And where that that wind of that heva where it go, most of the Guru Varga is. So our Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami appear very close to that. He took birth in Brahmin family, which is a very high class Brahmin family. Aishwarya, what is wealth? No, he's a very rich family. Very in bhakti. Look at Aishwarya. When Acharya was hardly 1.5 years, with 1.5 years. In Kartik 2016, Maharaj, he spoke in 2016, he spoke in Gopinath Bhavan and Gopinath Gaudiya Math. During that time, so many people came to listen to his katha. And so many got attracted to bhakti. And his end.
Even though
we have heard how Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj wanted to give him Acharya. He said, I'm not like Vasudev Vipra. They can sing this suffering of the others. When Narasimha Maharaj asked some benediction, he said, I want the sin of all the living entities, and I will go to hell for many of lifetimes. But would deliver all living entities? Then Narasimha Dev said, what's the need for you to take it? If this is a desire, I will deliver one Brahman.
इसलिए उन्होंने सब योग्यता रहते हुए भी
इवन ही हैज गॉट ऑल क्वालिटीज इवन दो ही वाज ऑल क्वालिटी स्टिल ही डिडंट हियर मी ही सेड आई डोंट आई हैव नॉट कम टू द स्टेज वेयर आई कैन डिलीवर ऑल दिस इवन दो
अंतिम समय में उनका गुरुजी का जो आदेश था
इन द फाइनल अंतिम समय इन द फाइनल टाइम ही फॉलोड His Gurudev's words and in being a and he got such in very small time he got such high qualified disciples. Sruta is gyan.
This
Hari Katha. When anyone is asking a question to Bhakti Vallabh Goswami Maharaj, if anyone asks him any question, if he said, whatever I have heard for Gurudev, I ask for, if you have any question, go to Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. You can get gyan from him. I used to stay in Rup Sanatan Gaudiya Math. So Narayan Goswami Maharaj used to ask me to go and invite all these sannyasis. Very close between Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj Srila Gurudev. So Gurudev used to specially say to me, definitely you should get special invitation Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. Gurudev used to always ask him to sum up with one day. Whenever he used to Maharaj, there was another Narayan.
लेकिन वो मेरे ऊपर भी इतनी गुस्सा करते थे जो ताल गुना शुरू करते थे बोले क्यों उनका बड़का भी महोत्सव है वहाँ भी महोत्सव है हाँ पूरी महाराज
Bhakti Prasad Pur Maharaj.
Bhakti Prasad.
He's got angry thing because they also Vinodvani. He's to get angry with me, so because I used to invite. He's to get angry with me because why? I used to invite Maharaj here because they want Maharaj to be in there itself. So Maharaj Gurudev is to order me to definitely bring. It was my duty to bring him in by car. Maharaj used to lovely give me prasad. In during the day of Gundicha Mandir Mahajan, all Vaishnavas used to be in Gundicha. We used to also go with Maharaj to Gundicha Mandir Mahajan. And Mr. Chaitanya Chaitmet. All Vaishnavas. He used to serve all the Vaishnava scriptures. Whoever comes, he used to tell me to hold me, give all Vaishnavas. He used to tell me, go and serve Vaishnava. Give prasad. During the time of building the all the temples built in Chaitanya Gaudiya Math, built most was done by Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati. I was there the time when they're building the temple. The appearance place of Bhakti Srila Prabhupada and Maharaj was personally involved with it. Is Harikatha Sri all not only devotees from India but all over the world, and especially our Mother Pitta Prabhu. What is heard from our Gurudev? What is heard from Bhakti Pramod? Heard from Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj Gurudev. And also,
he's
The people used to say things in sutra, so Madhav Priya Prabhu is explained very nicely. Madhav Priya Prabhu engaged so much seva in bhakti, vegan bhakti. And Sri, one is yes, and Sri means Sundar, beautiful. Therefore, if you see the beauty of who is Prabhupada, because he is the grandson of Prabhupada, and who is Prabhupada? That's so. That's good. Mahadabhuta pavana Shadabhadam Pranamami Sata Prabhu Padapadam.
Prabhupada Nain Mani Manjari.
Who is Prabhupada Nain Mani Manjari?
Bhakti Gomata Santa Goswami Maharaj told me Prabhupada ka jo rang hai na, Radha Rani ki rang.
The rang, the complexion of Radha Rani is Prabhupada is the same as Radha Rani. And same thing our Maharaj used to be so tall. Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he was very tall, very beautiful. That's why they used to stop him from going to the West, because the girls will be attracted to Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Therefore you see his complexion is so golden, just like so tall. Janma, Aishwarya, Sri, Yash, all four qualities were complete in Maharaj. Even though he had all these qualities, still he engaged in bhakti, Bhagavad Bhakti. That means he is not an ordinary person. The topmost qualities of Vaishnav, that has been explained in Bhagavatam, the 24 qualities. What is the topmost quality of devotee? Shine Shakti, tolerant. One who can tolerate, he can survive. He was so much, how much he tolerated. One time there was fighting between two sevaks.
Chugli.
He called, instead of, there were two, they attributed fault to Bhakti Vikyan Bharati Goswami, who was Narottam Das Brahmacharya. Even though he didn't do anything, they blamed him. Still he did not say anything. He will not say anything. He never used to take any fault. Even once there was fighting between Brahmacharis, and he didn't do any seva, so Maharaj took all the seva and said, doing marketing, makes he did all seva, collection and cooking and serving Thakurji, Aarti, everything, and seeing his seva, all Brahmacharis. Similarly, his action, unless he serves, he doesn't take prasad. His life is seva my jivan, complete. His life is seva. How he took one mantra, all the Vaishnavas, all Vaishnavas, he served all the disciples of Prabhupada, and he learned so many things from all of them. Vijay Krishna Prabhu said one thing with him.
अगर सारे प्रभुपाद का धन नहीं
अगर इनके जीवन को अगर पुखान पुख रूप में कोई जानता था मैं जो चीज चुना हूँ यही महापुरुष है।
Who is really
किसी गुरु वैष्णव का दिधि होता था हमारे महाराज राय पहले इनको बुलाते थे और इन्हीं को ही मिलता था कि सारे प्रभुपाद
anyone who has served a close relationship all the disciples और भक्ति सिद्धांत सर जी डिसिपल्स
इतना नहीं जानता था। एक दिन सुना तो उनको मुंह में मैं तो आश्चर्य में पड़ गया
that even my guru bhakti sirup siddhanti goswami because I've heard things from him that I didn't even know. By serving all of the Guru Varga, he has learned so many things from them. He took the essence from all the Vaishnavas. He disappeared from this place. We are full of anarthas and full of faults and offenses. So he please give mercy to all of us. How he served all the Guru Varga and how he made his life seva my jivan. He blesses all of us and pray. That somehow we can always be in the association and always be under the guidance of Vaishnavas, even if we get beaten by them and chastised, that we can always be under their foot dust and hold in the field. So we are praying. So I'm saying this, I will finish here. One chapter. Vaishnavebhyo namo namah, and thank you especially for Hari Vala Prabhu for translating. Now Aarti and Prashad, and many people have to go far places. Today is Sunday. Hold it. हरे कृष्ण ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ तिरुभाव तिथि ऑल द सन्यासी ब्रह्मचारी वैष्णव और वैष्णवी प्रेजेंट हियर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ श्री राधा माधव वी आर वेलकमिंग यू एंड थैंकिंग यू
क्योंकि महाराज जी के तिरुभाव तिथि का उपलक्ष्य है
बिकॉज इट शिला महाराज तिरुभाव तिथि
कुछ दिन पूर्व ही पास में हॉस्पिटल है
द हॉस्पिटल क्लोज बाय दिस इज क्यूआरजी हॉस्पिटल क्लोज बाय वेयर महाराज वाज
सब लेकर वहां चले गए
ऑन द डे राधा अष्टमी वी टू द सेवक
महाराज जी वहां पर है ना पसंद नहीं कर रहे
बट महाराज डिड नॉट लाइक स्टेइंग देयर डिड नॉट
वांट टू महाराज जी ने माधव प्रभु को बुलाकर
कहा टू माधव प्रभु
कि मैं यहां पर यमदूतों को देख रहा
हूं आई एम ओनली सीइंग यमदूत हियर
इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि महाराज जी यमदूतों को देख रहे हैं
इट डजंट रियली मीन दैट ही सीइंग यमदूत
यहां पर चारों और कौन है
बट ही सीइंग
डॉक्टर्स
नर्स
मैं यहां पर अपने प्राण नहीं छोड़ना चाहता
आई डोंट वांट टू लीव माय लाइफ
विश्व दूतों के मध्य अपने प्राणों को
त्याग आई वांट टू बी इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ विष्णु दूत
विष्णु दूत
मीन्स मठवासी
इसलिए मैं यहां नहीं रहना चाहता
सो आई डोंट स्टे इन द हॉस्पिटल आई वांट टू गो बैक टू द मठ How can we serve him and look after him? That the facilities are provided in hospital. They are professionals here. And all arrangements are here. And all medical equipment. Then Maharaj said, are you looking for your happiness or my happiness?
जब ये बात कही
when he said this,
तो थोड़ी सी विवशता हो गई
then there was some
कि महाराज जी तीव्र लालसा है कि मैं मठ में ही रहूं
some hesitation then महाराज really wants to go to the mutt even though we cannot provide all the facilities and there's some difficulty then he told Mahadev Prabhu
डॉक्टर से कह दो
tell the doctor
ये अस्पताल बहुत छोटा है
this hospital
इससे बड़ा हॉस्पिटल मिल गया
we going to a better hospital
इसलिए हम वहां पर ले जाएंगे
so we going to a better hospital this hospital is not so good
दूसरी बात ये भी कह दो
tell him
कि हमारे पास
and tell him we don't have any wealth
आपके बिल
so to pay your bill
महाराज जी कभी पूरे जीवन में मिथ्या कथा नहीं बोले।
इन लाइफ ही नेवर टोल्ड लाइज।
और ये जो दो वाक्य कहे,
दिस टू थिंग्स ही सेड,
उसका अर्थ भी महाराज जी ने ही बतलाया।
महाराज जी टोल्ड द रियल मीनिंग ऑफ व्हाट ही इज सेइंग,
कि इससे बड़ा हॉस्पिटल मिल गया हमको यहाँ से ले जाओ।
व्हाट इज अ बेटर हॉस्पिटल देन मेडिकल हॉस्पिटल।
कहना चाहते हैं
Because Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada says, Gaudiya Math is a hospital. Because everyone has come to get the treatment. Someone all got different diseases. This is multi-specialty hospital that we got so different diseases. There is no hospital greater than the Math, where subtle things are being diagnosed. So keeping this mind words of Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada, is therefore when we go to the hospital, that is the Gaudiya Math. And the other thing Maharaj said,
कि हमारे पास धन नहीं
है। We don't have wealth.
ये भी एक आश्चर्य वाली बात है।
So this is another thing.
तो उसमें भी महाराज जी का एक तात्पर्य था, एक अर्थ था।
What is the meaning Maharaj is giving there?
प्रेम धन बिना व्यर्थ दरिद्र
the जीवन। The Mahaprabhu has said this, that without the wealth of prem, I am in poverty.
दीनतापूर्वक महाराज जी कह रहे हैं, जो वाक्य श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी कहते थे,
and make me your das and give me a wages of prem. Mahaprabhu is saying, I don't even have a smell of prem. So this is the nature of devotee. Even though when they have prem, they always manifest that we don't have prem. And that lacking is always there because of high class association. When you have high class, automatically you feel lacking. I'm trying to same thing for myself. One
sevak,
and there's one volunteer.
We should do
our self-assessment. Are we sevaks or are we volunteers? Volunteer does whatever he desires, whatever he likes. He is not bound by it. And he has no responsibility. If you desire to serve, and then he will not. If he doesn't desire, if he likes, he will do serve. If he doesn't like, I will. I don't have anything to do with that.
कैसी भी परिस्थिति क्यों ना हो,
बट सेवक इन एनी सिचुएशन,
वो अपनी सेवा से जो कमिटेड है उसे कभी चूकता नहीं।
He doesn't give up his commitment to serve. He doesn't give up his responsibility whether he is favorable or unfavorable. He takes it responsibility.
और सेवा के प्रति responsible होकर
he takes responsibility towards
सेवा को करना
and does all types of सेवा।
वो अनुकूल प्रतिकूल को एक समान मानता हुआ,
he takes both anukul and pratikul, favorable and unfavorable, tolerating the favorable and unfavorable, and always engage in the service of Gurudev, Vaishnavas, and taking all responsibility. Seva.
और जो volunteer है, क्या दोनों को एक ही प्रकार का आशीर्वाद प्राप्त होगा?
So does the seva and the volunteer get the same blessing, same reward? Seva gets the reward like a seva.
क्योंकि seva के अधीन है भगवान.
And Bhagwan is under the control of sevak, not under the control of volunteers.
Bhagwan कह रहे हैं दुर्वासा जी को, मेरे सेवक ने, मेरे भक्तों ने मुझको वशीभूत कर लिया।
So Bhagwan is saying, दुर्वासा, that my devotees, my sevaks have controlled me.
सेवक और volunteer की परिभाषा के साथ साथ भी ये जो सेवक सेवा करता है वो अनकंडीशनल होती है।
The seva that the sevak does is unconditional. There is no condition.
वो अहेतु की
है। That is causeless. That means without.
यदि हम आरंभ में ही ये कह दें,
if we say in the beginning,
मैं तभी सेवा करूँगा जब मुझको सुख और आनंद ही मिलेगा।
I will only do seva.
कंडीशन लगाती हूँ सेवा।
Well, if I get happiness, then that is a condition in seva.
जबकि वो सेवा unconditional
है। Seva is unconditional. He doesn't expect anything. What is the goal of the sevak? Just like
how
did the gopis do
seva?
Gopis seva is unconditional.
और इसी संबंध में श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी ने जो आठवां श्लोक उच्चारण किया
इन दिस एइथ श्लोक ऑफ शिष्यास्तकम अशिष्टेव पदार्थम पिनाष्टुम
यथा तथा व विधातो लंपटो व प्राणनाथस्तेव महाराज जी बतला रहे हैं ये चरम सीमा है
दिस इज दिस टॉप मोस्ट लिमिट ऑफ अनकंडीशनल लव
ये सेवा का
If you give, oh Krishna, if you give me sukh, whether you give me darshan, if you don't give, or make us sad by not giving darshan, but you are a master, Lord, and I will not give up yourself. Volunteer gives up the seva when he's in unfavorable conditions. Dr. has said, he said in this relation, that if any distress I get in your service, that is the topmost happiness. This is Bhakti Natakur, this is the topmost happiness I am getting. This is that. Because the center is, this is the mood of a sevak, not a volunteer. In Jagannath Puri, in Gundicha Mandir, but during the time of Gundicha Mandir, some devotees took his permission and went for Gundicha Mandir Mahajan and all the devotees and later the Mother Prabhu he didn't go to all went to Gundicha Mandir Mahajan then who will look after you Mother Prabhu said who will go if you something Maharaj ji said that Uttam Sevak All those who went, they did not, they followed Maryada, got his permission, they did not do any
fault.
Prem Rajya,
kingdom of
that even Maryada sinks in that. That is the topmost Rajya. Where there is nothing of happiness. Not own Ishta
Sukh.
Aparam
Sukh.
That they give up own that you give up your own happiness or your sadness for the service, for the happiness for your Ishtadev, if you of Guru Devaishnavas. Therefore this one, two things are there are so many instructions.
He
gave so much
teaching.
There are many things that we did not
hear.
Anugatya my jivan. Always be under the guidance of to be under the guidance of Vaishnava is the topmost life, is the best life, is one because if one gives up if one doesn't take anugatya, he will anugatya. Independence means volunteer mood.
गुरु अनुगत्य वैष्णव अनुगत्य नहीं
गुरु वैष्णव
श्री राधा कृष्ण की लीलाओं में भी वह अनुगत्य देखा जाता
है दिस अनुगत्य इज इन एवरी प्रेजेंट नॉट ओनली इन दिस लाइफ बट आल्सो इन द स्पिरिचुअल इन पैटाग्राम महाराज के वेरी नाइस एग्जांपल इन द पास्ट टाइम ऑफ पैटाग्राम
जहां पर श्री कृष्ण चतुर्भुज नारायण रूप में विराजमान समस्त गोपियां उन नारायण को प्रणाम करके आगे चली गईं
When Krishna took the form of Narayan, when the gopis, some gopis went in front of, before Radharani and they offered pranam, Narayan left. And there were some gopis who were behind Radharani and Radharani came there. Krishna could not hold his four hands and he came back to his two-handed form. But only who saw this form? Radharani and those gopis who were behind. Radharani, that means who under the guidance of Radharani. This life means the topmost life is to be under the guidance of Guru and Vaishnavas. So it not only applies in this life, in this world, but also in the spiritual world. There's so much teachings. These teachings, his conduct, his teachings, his siddhanta that he present may be available in our heart. So we're praying to him. Avnibhyo Vaishnavibhyo.
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु जी कह रहे हैं वैष्णव के लिए इस घर में प्रसाद की व्यवस्था है और क्योंकि लोग बहुत सारे हैं स्थान थोड़ा सा स्थान का अभाव है इसलिए जो लोग कुछ समय अपेक्षा कर सकते हैं वो बाद में प्रसाद पा लेंगे जिन लोगों से नीचे बेसमेंट में प्रसाद की व्यवस्था है तो धीरे धीरे भक्तों प्रसाद परिवेशन करेंगे जो लोग अपेक्षा करते हैं कर सकते हैं वो 5-7 मिनट बाद या अगली बार में प्रसाद पा लेंगे तो यहाँ भीतर में भी प्रभु जी कह रहे यहाँ भी प्रसाद पवा देंगे हमारे महाराज जी एक मास तक दिल्ली में आकर के रहे थे
महाराष्ट्र इन दिल्ली वन मंथ दिस इज ईस्ट ऑफ कैलाश ही इज टू स्टे
भंडारा हुआ
एंड लास्ट इज
भंडारा जब बहुत अच्छे से हो गया
एंड वाज लास्ट डे
जाकर के महाराज जी से कहा कि महाराज जी आज का कार्यक्रम बहुत अच्छा हुआ
आई सेड वेरी नाइस
कहते किस दिन खराब होता
है व्हिच इज गेटिंग माय बैड
महाराज जी कहते किस दिन खराब होता है तो इसलिए महाराज जी की कृपा से
हमारे
गुरु महाराज जी की कृपा से हमारे पूज्यपाद माधव प्रिय प्रभु पूज्यपाद सिद्धांत महाराज जी पूज्यपाद श्रद्धा महाराज जी सब वैष्णव की कृपा से बड़ा ही अच्छा हमारा उत्सव हो गया एक और बात बस मैं कह दूं मेरा स्मरण हो गया
सनातन गोस्वामी से
कहते हैं कि महाजन जो होते हैं ना महाजन
दो
श्रेष्ठ पुरुष होते हैं
महाजन दो
श्रेष्ठ गुण होता है
इज वन स्पेशल क्वालिटी
क्या होता है
व्हाट इज दैट
इतने श्रेष्ठ पद पर होने पर भी
इवन दो इज सच हाई क्वालिटी
निकट में उनके साथ में जो लोग रहते हैं
दोस पीपल स्टे क्लोज
कभी अनुभव नहीं होने देते कि मैं इतना श्रेष्ठ हूं
दे डोंट रियलाइज दैट दैट पर्सन इज सच हाई दे डोंट मेक हिम डिफरेंट
इस विषय में बताया
करते हैं
कृष्ण जमुना के तट पर
Krishna is sitting. He is sitting with his associates and taking picnic with his good friends. They never felt Krishna is such a is a supreme person.
तुम एक साधारण ग्वाले जैसे हो जाते हो साधारण नहीं है किंतु फिर भी कृष्ण के साथ में तो कोई तुलना नहीं है श्री बृहद भागवत अमृतम में श्री सनातन गोस्वामी जी कहते हैं महाजनों का ये वैशिष्ट्य
दिस स्पेशलिटी ऑफ महाजन दिस स्पेशल
पर साथ में रहने वाले लोग
दे दोस हु स्टे क्लोज टू हिम दे नेवर फील दैट ही इज सो
हाई महाराज जी के जीवन
वी सो दिस इन आवर महाराज
गुरु महाराज जी के
गुरु महाराज
दोनों के जीवन में
सो इन बोथ
दैट इस आदर्श को इस गुण को बड़े सुंदर रूप में प्रदर्शित होते हैं
सी वेरी गुड क्वालिटी
निकट में रहने वाले सेवक लोग जो बहुत छोटे छोटे से सेवक लोग आयु में भी छोटे ज्ञान में भी छोटे
द सेवक सो वेरी यंग एंड वेरी नियोफाइट स्टिल दे नेवर सो दैट गुरु ओ वैष्णव
गुरु भाई ने हमारी उनसे उनके साथ में चर्चा हो रही थी और उन्होंने कहा किसी विषय पर हमने उनसे वार्तालाप कर रहे थे
तो गुरु भाई
जो लोग गुरु महाराज जी के निकट में रहे अथवा जो लोग महाराज जी के निकट में रहे जब उनको महाराज जी की गुरु जी की स्मृति होती है ना तो स्वाभाविक रूप में हृदय भर जाता है
कंठ
अवरुद्ध हो जाता है नेत्रों से अश्रु आ जाते हैं बड़ा अभाव अनुभव होता है बड़ा अभाव तो उन्होंने कहा प्रभु जी बात ठीक है अभाव तो अनुभव होता है किंतु अब नहीं मिल रहा है संग तो अब जो वैष्णव है उनके साथ में रह करके पारमार्थिक जीवन को आगे बढ़ाया जाए बात तो ठीक है किंतु क्या इस बात को भाषा के द्वारा समझाया जा सकता है गुरु जी के निकट में जिनको रहने का सौभाग्य
मिला
गुरु की मधुर स्मृतियां
हैं प्रसाद
अपने थाले से उठा करके दे देते हैं अपने निकट में बैठा करके कभी कहते हैं अरे हमारा सर में तेल लगा दो कभी चरण चापन कर दो कभी
मसाज मी और क्लीन माय बेड
हमारे लिए पैसे गिन दो
खान
बोला करते थे हमारे पैसे गिन दो कभी हास परिहास करते कभी प्रसाद पाते पाते उसी थाले से प्रसाद उठाकर दे देते
समटाइम लेके प्रसाद
समझ करके शासन भी करते
और समटाइम थिंग अब
जस्ट भाव मिला है
दोज
हैव गॉट कोई तो अभाव अनुभव होगा
दे ओनली देयर
फील नहीं होगा तो ये जो भावना है ना जब ये तिथियों पर स्मृति होती है जैसा प्रभु जी बतला रहे थे ना प्रारंभ में क्यों होता है यह भाव क्योंकि कहीं ना कहीं भाव स्पर्श हुआ है ना हृदय में उन महापुरुषों के साथ में गुरु जी के साथ में महाराज जी के साथ में जो वार्तालाप रहा जो संग
जो सुयोग मिला है उसी को
जो स्मरण करके मन में भावना फूटती है ना जैसे ब्रजवासियों को जो भाव मिला है वो
द्वारकावासी को मिला कभी कृष्ण ने
देवी मैया की गोद में चढ़ करके उनका स्तनपान किया
यशोदा
मैया का तो हजार बार किया कभी तो मैया को
residents of Dwarka and Mathura, they cannot realize this thing, but now they have this more similar. Therefore, like Devaki Mata never gave breast milk to Krishna. Those who stayed next Gurudev or Guru Shivarti, Gurudev has nourished all of them. He's nurtured all of them. Someone asked Gurudev, his Gurudev is Samdarshi, he has mercy to all, he has equal mercy. But it depends on the proportion of surrender of the disciple. One disciple, one disciple who is completely is accepting everything and chastisement and everything, and always engage himself. So the mercy Gurudev gives is never equal. It depends on the proportion of surrender and how much dedicated is to be. So remembering the thing when we stayed close to Maharaj, the exchanges we had, the opportunity to them, we can get this service nirantar.
So,
if I knew that Krishna goes to Mathura, I will never mind. Those got fortunate to stay associated with Maharaj, some lacking is feeling. By mercy of Maharaj, everything happened nicely. Praying to Gurudev, Maharaj, Srila Bhakti, that we can get directly, we can get his association and the service and mercy. Praying the lotus feet. After this, we'll do prasad preparation.
राधा माधव गौड़ी मठ से हम लोग जगन्नाथ पुरी धाम यात्रा में जा रहे हैं।
यू गोइंग टू जगन्नाथ पुरी
6 अक्टूबर से 9 अक्टूबर। यदि आप लोग इच्छुक होंगे तो संपर्क करें।